you dead.
What's up, you all? I want to start by saying, first off, thank you, and thank you so much to each and every last positive words of encouragement, prayers, or whatever that I received from so many of you all. I did receive a few little negative Nancys, and you know, it's kind of crazy because I don't really want to put my energy into what the negative people have to say. So instead of doing that, I'm not only going to praise you all that actually took the time to out your day to give me so much encouragement, prayers, or just sweet things that you've stated to me about my current situation or whatever, and about losing my job, okay? All I want to say is, for all those in the comments like, you're a dumb A, blah, 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 BBB, this, blah, 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 you, it's your own fault, I would never give no prayers for you, B, I just want to say that I truly, truly, truly hope that not only God, but life sends you so many blessings, okay? So that you can take some of that hate out your heart and you can fulfill that, those empty holes with love, joy, and positivity. Because what one thing that I understand that we don't take into consideration is what our parents taught us a long time ago. If we have nothing nice to say, don't say it. There's so much chaos and hate already in the world. We don't need more hate on top of that. So I would kindly appreciate it if you took that hate and you transferred that into love, or transferred it into finding a life, a clue, God, prayer, you know what I'm saying? What I want to start off by saying is, you all, I am 100% aware that yes, I was on the clock recording videos in some of my videos, but that is not the issue. I fully understand that now. You get what I'm saying? Like, if this is all my fault, I will take 150,000% credibility that, hey, yeah, this is my fault and I'm all to blame. But I just don't think fully that it just lands on me. Okay, you all, like I was trying to tell you all, okay, first off, the Meek and Jimmy channel, I have been doing videos on this channel for a year and some change now, okay? D'Amica Rochelle channel, where my music videos as an artist, I've been doing that for years, okay? I've been at my job for 6 years, okay? Now, I don't know who all are the mathematic geniuses out there, but let me tell you this. A lot of my videos happened during break time, during off the clock, during in my personal home, personal whatever. You get what I'm saying? And it's like, for me to be at an establishment for 6 years and some change away from being at 7 years, I didn't receive a warning. I didn't receive a referral. I didn't receive any of that above. You get what I'm saying? Even if it was in my handbook, for my own manager to even know what I do, and like I said, been in some of my vlogs, and some employees been in some of my vlogs, for them to know what I do and say, hey, D'Amica, have you checked the handbook lately? This is, you know what I'm saying? Had I knew that, or had somebody had brought that to my attention that, hey, on your break time, you still can't record because you're on our property. Yes, I'm aware that they didn't hire me to make videos, which is why I made the videos on my own time, which is my break time, which is, by law, you have to take a break. What I decided to do during my break time was my time. You get what I'm saying? And if that's wrong, then so be it. I could take full responsibility for doing videos on their time. I get that. I truly, truly, honestly, I get that. Now that I know moving forward, I will never do another video while at work. I don't care what the circumstances is. You get what I'm saying? But it's just the principle that what I don't understand, and which I never received an understanding for, is I've been there for 6 years. All of a sudden, once I start talking about a Kanika Jenkins situation, now I'm under investigation, now I lose my job. You get what I'm saying? It's not that, oh yeah, it was just a matter of time that before it catched up with you. It's you all, I don't know. Sorry, my camera died. But it's just the principle that you all, it just doesn't add up. You get what I'm saying? For this to just happen out the blue, why didn't it happen last year? The year before that? The year before that? Hell, why didn't it happen a year within working within the company? Because I have been doing videos. You get what I'm saying? It's not about, oh yeah, because you were making Kanika Jenkins video and you were whispering in your videos saying that you were at work. Yes, I was at work. Yes, I was whispering. And also, I was on break. I take my lunch break. If I'm not in the gym at my job, I take them at my desk. For the last 2 weeks that I've been on this Kanika Jenkins case, per my Twitter, I have been sitting at my desk trying to figure out what is going on. I didn't go to the gym. You get what I'm saying? And it's just like, I don't know if somebody was on some type of hate mess and had these folks look into my personal business, my personal life, and my personal videos, but that does seem to be what took place because it doesn't make sense. Do I want you all to feel sorry for me? No, because if it is 100% my fault, then by all means, I'm a grown woman. I'm 27 years old with 3 kids, okay? I can take responsibility. I have no problem taking responsibility and saying, hey, you know what, Jamika, that was all the way your fault. But the simple fact that I just don't agree that it was 100% my fault, being that I had an own manager in my videos. Nobody brought this to my attention. Nobody said, hey, you can't do this. They said, hey, you're vlogging? Oh, what's up, vlog? It's like, you know, I don't know if this is, maybe they've been wanting me out of the company, whether somebody was hating or whatever the case may be. I see a few comments saying that Tommy reported me. I don't even, who is Tommy? I don't even know Tommy. If you all can explain what is Tommy, this Tommy situation that keeps coming up in my comments, please explain that down below for me. And also, a lot of you have asked, do I have a GoFundMe? Do I have a PayPal? I do have a PayPal. Do I have a GoFundMe? No, I do not have a GoFundMe. I don't even feel right taking money from complete strangers. But do I appreciate the notion? Heck yeah, because that's what we need more of. More unity, more people to pick up each other when they see that somebody that's not even them, that doesn't have nothing to do with their life, their circumstances. If you see that person down, if you can do something in your power, in your might, to turn somebody's day around, whether it's financially, whether it's through prayer, whether it's through advice, whether it's through positivity, then by all means, do that. That is a purpose-filled life because you're doing your assignment in life, which is loving and being compassionate for others. All this extra stuff where we like to turn our eyes and our head and our ears on other people's problems because it has nothing to do with us, that we don't have time for that in life, because there is a point in life where we could be up today, down tomorrow, and there's also a point in life where we all will need each other, which is why we can't afford to have black and white issues going on. We can only afford to be unified and to stand together, which is why I've been trying to figure out what is going on with this girl. This girl has nothing to do with me, but yet she touched a chord with me because I was 19. I was Kanika Jenkins. I was partying. I was doing things that I was not supposed to be doing at her age. You get what I'm saying? And you know, y'all, let me know in the comments if you all really, really, really honestly want me to do a GoFundMe account or want to link any type of, you know, gain, whether it's a dollar to me, 50 cents, I don't even care. If you all want me to do that, I will link the information down below for you all. And I appreciate it from the bottom of my heart because you all don't know me from a can of paint. And for you all to take time once again out your day and out your time to put so much joy back into my life in a time where I'm just feeling a little bit hit, a little bit broken, and a little bit hurt behind it. And it's just like, I appreciate that. And for that, I don't know, you know, I could spend the rest of my life trying to repay everyone for you all's comments. But like I said, if you all want me to do a GoFundMe account and you don't have an issue and you're not going, you know what I'm saying, I'm not going to have to hear no backlash from it, no negativity from it, by all means, let me know and I will open it. But at this time, I don't have one open because I don't even feel right asking complete strangers to help me for something that, you know, it happened. You get what I'm saying? And it's like, I just wanted to take this time and to just say, look, y'all, it's not about that I was on the clock whispering and I made these videos. Yes, Now that I know moving forward, yes, I take full responsibility for that. It's just a simple fact that I do feel like somebody had gave them a heads up and let them know, and probably let them know something different. I don't really know. It's in God's hands. Today's a new day. I know that He's going to bless me with something else. I know it. I have a calling over my life, you all, and I can't explain that to you all, especially to those who don't understand the spiritual realm of things in life. But let me tell you something. My God did not bring me this far to ever let me go. I've been through hell and high waters. Do you hear what I'm saying? From the time that I was 16 on up till now, that shit will bring tears to my eyes, because you all don't understand the year that I've had and the peace that I still have in my mind. The goal is to make me go crazy. That's what the goal of this whole year has been. But let me tell you something. I'm at peace. I'm good. And though I cry, it's because I know that a breakthrough is gonna come through. And yes, I'm human. I can cry. You get what I'm saying? But that doesn't ding me as being a weak individual. I'm crying because I know at the end of this, I have to have a testimony. God's been here with me too long, too strong for me not to have a testimony and for me not to come out on top on the other side and singing nothing but praise and joy. So, you all, if you're a praying person, if you're a positive person, if you care anything about this video, anything about me, you know, continue to pray for me. Continue to lift me up. But if you can't do that, please find you another channel to go to. I don't need your hate. The world doesn't need your hate. We need more love. We don't have a time for hate. Bye, y'all.
With my little eye, a girly I can get, cause she don't get too many likes. A curly headed cutie I could turn into my wife. Wait, that means forever, ever, hold up, never mind. Oh, I spy with my little eye, a girly I can get, cause she don't get too many likes. A curly headed cutie I could turn into my wife. Wait, that means forever, ever.